The Portuguese, Os Lusiadas. By Luís Vaz de Camoies. Podcast 3 of 10. Book 3. The Argument. Gama, in reply to the King of Melinda, describes the various countries of Europe, narrates the rise of the Portuguese nation. History of Portugal. Battle of Guimarães. Agas offers himself with his wife and family for the honor of his country. Alonso pardons him. Battle of Aurique against the Moors, great slaughter of the Moors. Alonso proclaimed King of Portugal on the battlefield of Aurique. At Badajoz he is wounded and taken prisoner, resigns the kingdom to his son, Don Sancho. Hearing that 13 Moorish kings, headed by the Emperor of Morocco, were besieging Sancho in Santarém, he hastens to deliver his son, gains a great battle, in which the Moorish emperor is slain. Victories of Sancho, capture of Silves from the Moors, and of Tui from the King of Leon. Conquest of Alcázar de Sul by Alfonso II. Deposition of Sancho II. Is succeeded by Alfonso III, the conqueror of Algarve, succeeded by Dionysius, founder of the University of Coimbra. His son, Alfonso the Brave. Affecting story of the fair Inés, who is crowned Queen of Portugal after her assassination. Don Pedro, her husband, rendered desperate by the loss of his mistress, is succeeded by the weak and effeminate Ferdinand. His wife Eleonora, torn from the arms of her lawful husband, disannuls his reign. End of the argument. Commence. O now, Calliope, thy potentate. What to the king th illustrious Gama said. Clothe in immortal verse. With sacred fire. My breast, if eer it loved thy lore, inspire. So may the patron of the healing art. The god of day to thee consign his heart. From thee, the mother of his darling son. May never wandering thought to Daphne run. May never Clytia, nor Lucathoe's pride. Henceforth with thee his changeful love divide. Then aid, O fairest nymph, my fond desire. And give my verse the Lusian warlike fire. Furred by the song, the listening world shall know. That Aganippe's streams from Tagus flow. Oh, let no more the flowers of Pindus shine. On thy fair breast, or round thy temples twine. On Tagus' banks a richer chaplet blows. And with the tuneful god my bosom glows. I feel the mighty power infuse. And bathe my spirit in Aeonian dews. Now silence wooed the illustrious chief's reply. And keen attention watched on every eye. When slowly turning with a modest grace. The noble Vasco writhed his manly face. O mighty king, he cries, at thy command. The martial story of my native land. I tell, but more my doubtful heart had joyed. Had other wars my praiseful lips employed. When men the honors of their race commend. The doubts of strangers on the tale attend. Yet, though reluctance falter on my tongue. Though day would fail a narrative so long. Yet, well assert no fiction's glare can raise. Or give my country's fame a brighter praise. Though less, far less, whate'er my lips can say. Then truth must give it, I thy will obey. Between that zone where endless winter reigns. And that where flaming heat consumes the plains. Arrayed in green, beneath indulgent skies. The queen of arts and arms, fair Europe lies. Around her northern and her western shores. Thronged with the finny race old ocean roars. The midland sea, where tide ne'er swelled the waves. Her richest lawns, the southern border, laves. Against the rising morn, the northmost bound. The whirling Tanis parts from Asian ground. As tumbling from the Scythian mountains cold. Their crooked way the rapid waters hold. To dull Myotis Lake. Her eastern line. More to the south, the Phrygian waves confine. Those waves, which, black with many a navy, bore. The Grecian heroes to the Dardan shore. Where now the seaman, wrapped in mournful joy. Explores in vain the sad remains of Troy. Wide to the north beneath the pole she spreads. Here piles of mountains rear their rugged heads. Here winds on winds in endless tempests roll. The valleys sigh, the lengthening echoes howl. On the rude cliffs, with frosty spangles gray, weak as the twilight, gleams the solar ray. Each mountain's breast with snows eternal shines. The streams and seas eternal frost confines. Here dwelt the number Rao Scythian tribes of old. A dreadful race. By victor ne'er controlled. Whose pride maintained that theirs the sacred earth. Not that of Nile, which first gave man his birth. Here dismal Lapland spreads a dreary wild. Here Norway's wastes, where harvest never smilled. Whose groves of fir in gloomy horror frown. Nod o'er the rocks, and to the tempest groan. Here Scandia's clime her rugged shores extends. And, far projected, through the ocean bends. Whose sons dread footsteps yet Ausonia wears. And yet proud Rome in mournful ruin bears. When summer bursts stern winter's icy chain. Here the bold Swede, the Prussian, and the Dane. Hoist the white sail and plough the foamy way. Cheered by whole months of one continual day. Between these shores and Tanna's rushing tide. Livonia's sons and Russia's hordes reside. Stern as there climb the tribes, whose sires of yore. The name, far dreaded, of Sarmatians bore. Where, famed of old, th Hercynian forest lowered. Oft seen in arms the Polish troops are poured. Wide foraging the downs. The Saxon race. The Hungar dext rouse in the wild boar chase. The various nations whom the Rhine's cold wave. The Elbe, Amasis, and the Danube lave. Of various tongues, for various princes known. Their mighty lord the German emperor own. Between the Danube and the Lucid tide. Where hapless Heli left her name, and died. The dreadful god of battle's kindred race. Degenerate now, possess the hills of Thrace. Mount Hemus here, and Rhodope renowned. And proud Byzantium, long with empire crowned. Their ancient pride, their ancient virtue fled. Low to the Turk now bend the servile head. Here spread the fields of warlike Macedon. And here those happy lands where genius shone. In all the arts, in all the muses' charms. In all the pride of elegance and arms. Which to the heavens resounded Grecia's name. And left in every age a deathless fame. The stern Dalmatians till the neighboring ground. And where Antenor anchored in the sound. Proud Venice, as a queen, majestic towers. And o'er the trembling waves her thunder pours. For learning glorious, glorious for the sword. While Rome's proud monarch reigned the world's dread lord. Here Italy her beauteous landscapes shows. Around her sides his arms old ocean throws. The dashing waves the ramparts aid supply. The hoary Alps high towering to the sky. From shore to shore a rugged barrier spread. And lower destruction on the hostile tread. But now no more her hostile spirit burns. There now the saint, in humble vespers mourns. To heaven more grateful than the pride of war. And all the triumphs of the victor's car. Onward fair Gallia opens to the view. Her groves of olive, and her vineyards blue. Widespread her harvests o'er the scenes renowned. Where Julius proudly strode with laurel crowned. Here Seine, how fair when glistening to the moon. Rolls his white wave, and here the cold Garun. Here the deep Rhine the flowery margin laves. And here the rapid Rhone impervious raves. Here the gruff mountains, faithless to the vows. Of lost Pyrene rear their cloudy brows. Whence, when of old the flames their woods devoured. Streams of red gold and melted silver poured. And now, as head of all the lordly train. Of Europe's realms, appears illustrious Spain. Alas, what various fortunes has she known. Yet ever did her sons her wrongs atone. Short was the triumph of her haughty foes. And still with fairer bloom her honors rose. Where, locked with land, the struggling currents boil. Famed for the godlike Theban's latest toil. Against one coast the Punic strand extends. Around her breast the midland ocean bends. Around her shores two various oceans swell, and various nations in her bosom dwell. Such deeds of valor dignify their names. Each the imperial right of honor claims. Proud Aragon, who twice her standard reared in conquered Naples, and for art revered, Galicia's prudent sons, the fierce Navarre, and he far dreaded in the Moorish war, the bold Asturian, nor Sevilla's race, nor thine, Granada, claim the second place. Here too the heroes who command the plain, by Betis watered, here the pride of Spain. The brave Castilian pauses o'er his sword, his country's dread deliverer and lord. Proud o'er the rest, with splendid wealth arrayed, as crown to this wide empire, Europe's head. Fair Lusitania smiles, the western bound, whose verdant breast the rolling waves surround, where gentle evening pours her lambent ray, the last pale gleaming of departing day. This, O mighty king, the sacred earth, this the loved parent soil that gave me birth. And oh, would bounteous heaven my prayer regard, and fair success my perilous toils reward. May that dear land my latest breath receive, and give my weary bones a peaceful grave. Sublime the honors of my native land, and high in heaven's regard her heroes stand. By heaven's decree 'twas theirs the first to quell the Moorish tyrants, and from Spain expel. Nor could their burning wilds conceal their flight. Their burning wilds confess the Lusian might. From Lusus famed, whose honored name we bear, the son of Bacchus or the bold compere, the glorious name of Lusitania rose. A name tremendous to the Roman foes. When her bold troops the valiant shepherd led, and foul with rout the Roman eagles fled. When haughty Rome achieved the treach rouse blow, that owned her terror of the matchless foe. But, when no more her Viriatus fought, age after age her deeper thraldom brought, her broken sons by ruthless tyrants spurned, her vineyards languished, and her pastures mourned, till time revolving riced her drooping head, and o'er the wandering world her conquests spread. Thus rose her power, the lands of lordly Spain were now the brave Alonso's wide domain. Great were his honors in the bloody fight, and fame proclaimed him champion of the right. And oft the groaning Saracen's proud crest, and shattered mail his awful force confessed. From Calp's summits to the Caspian shore, loud-tongued renown his godlike actions bore. And many a chief from distant regions came to share the laurels of Alonso's fame. Yet, more for holy faith's unspotted cause, their spears they wielded, than for fame's applause. Great were the deeds their thundering arms displayed, and still their foremost swords the battle swayed. And now to honor with distinguished meed, each hero's worth the generous king decreed. The first and bravest of the foreign bands, Hungary's younger son, brave Henry stands. To him are given the fields where Tagus flows, and the glad king his daughter's hand bestows. The fair Teresa shines his blooming bride, and owns her father's love, and Henry's pride. With her, besides, the sire confirms in dower, what her his sword might rescue from the Moor. And soon on Hager's race the hero powers, his warlike fury soon the vanquished Moors. To him far round the neighboring lands resign, and heaven rewards him with a glorious line. To him is born, heaven's gift, a gallant son, the glorious founder of the Lusian throne. Nor Spain's wide lands alone his deeds attest, delivered Judah Henry's might confessed. On Jordan's bank the victor hero strode, whose hallowed waters bathed the Savior God, and Salem's gate her open folds displayed, when Godfrey conquered by the hero's aid. But now no more intented fields opposed, by Tagus' stream his honored age he clost. Yet still his dauntless worth, his virtue lived, and all the father in the son survived. And soon his worth was proved, the parent dame avowed a second hymeneal flame. The lowborn spouse assumes the monarch's place, and from the throne expels the orphan race. but young Alfonso, like his sires of yore. His grandsire's virtues, as his name, he bore. Arms for the fight, his ravished throne to win. And the lacked helmet grasps his beardless chin. Her fiercest firebrand civil discord waved. Before her troops the lustful mother raved. Lost to maternal love, and lost to shame. Unabed she saw heaven's awful vengeance flame. The brother's sword the brother's bosom tore. And sad Gamaria's meadows blushed with gore. With Lusian gore the peasant's cot was stained. And kindred blood the sacred shrine profaned. Here, cruel Progne, here, O Jason's wife. Yet reeking with your children's purple life. Here glut your eyes with deeper guilt than yours. Here fiercer rage her fiercer rancor powers. Your crime was vengeance on the faithless sires. But here ambition with foul lust conspires. 'Twas rage of love, O Scylla, urged the knife. That robbed thy father of his fated life. Here grosser rage the mother's breast inflames. And at her guiltless son the vengeance aims. But aims in vain, her slaughtered forces yield. And the brave youth rides victor o'er the field. No more his subjects lift the thirsty sword. And the glad realm proclaims the youthful lord. But ah, how wild the noblest tempers run. His filial duty now forsakes the son. Secluded from the day, in clanking chains. His rage the parents' aged limbs constrains. Heaven frowned dark vengeance lowering on his brows. And sheathed in brass, the proud Castilian rose. Resolved the rigor to his daughter shone. The battle should avenge, and blood atone. A numerous host against the prince he sped. The valiant prince his little army led. Dire was the shock, the deep-riven helms resound. And foes with foes lie grappling on the ground. Yet, though around the stripling's sacred head, by angel hands ethereal shields were spread. Though glorious triumph on his valor smiled. Soon on his van the baffled foe recoiled. With bands more number roused to the field he came. His proud heart burning with the rage of shame. And now in turn Gamaria's lofty wall. That saw his triumph, saw the hero fall. Within the town immured, distressed he lay. To stern Castilia's sword a certain prey. When now the guardian of his infant years. The valiant Agos, as a god appears. To proud Castile the suppliant noble bows. And faithful homage for his prince he vows. The proud Castile accepts his honored faith. And peace succeeds the dreadful scenes of death. Yet well, alas, the generous Agos knew. His high-souled prince to man would never sue. Would never stoop to brook the servile stain. To hold a borrowed, a dependent reign. And now with gloomy aspect rose the day. Decreed the plighted servile rights to pay. When Agos, to redeem his faith's disgrace. Devotes himself, his spouse, and infant race. In gowns of white, as sentenced felons clad. When to the stake the sons of guilt are led. With feet unshod they slowly moved along. And from their necks the knotted halters hung. And now, O king, the kneeling Agos cries. Behold my perjured honor's sacrifice. If such mean victims can atone thine ire. Here let my wife, my babes, myself expire. If Genrau's bosom such revenge can take. Here let them perish for the father's sake. The guilty tongue, the guilty hands are these. Nor let a common death thy wrath appease. For us let all the rage of torture burn. But to my prince, thy son, in friendship turn. He spoke, and bowed his prostrate body low. As one who waits the lifted saber's blow. When o'er the block his languid arms are spread. And death, foretasted, whelms the heart with dread. So great a leader thus in humbled state. So firm his loyalty, his zeal so great. The brave Alonso's kindled ire subdued. And, lost in silent joy, the monarch stood. Then gave the hand, and sheathed the hostile sword. And, to such honor honored peace restored. O Lusian faith! O zeal beyond compare! What greater danger could the Persian dare? whose prince in tears, to view his mangled woe, forgot the joy for Babylon's o'erthrow. And now the youthful hero shines in arms. The banks of Tagus echo war's alarms. O'er Aurich's wide campaign his ensigns wave, and the proud Saracen to combat brave. Though prudence might arraign his fiery rage, that dared with one, each 100 spears engage. In heaven's protecting care his courage lies, and heaven, his friend, superior force supplies. 5 Moorish kings against him march along. Ismar the noblest of the armed throng. Yet each brave monarch claimed the soldier's name, and far o'er many a land was known to fame. In all the beauteous glow of blooming years, beside each king a warrior nymph appears. Each with her sword her valiant lover guards, with smiles inspires him, and with smiles rewards. Such was the valor of the beauteous maid, whose warlike arm proud Ilion's fate delayed. Such in the field the virgin warriors shone, who drank the limpid wave of Thermodon. 'Twas morn still hour, before the dawning gray, the star's bright twinkling radiance died away. When lo, resplendent in the heaven serene, high o'er the prince the sacred cross was seen. The godlike prince with faith's warm glow inflamed. "Oh, not to me, my bounteous God!" exclaimed. "Oh, not to me, who well thy grandeur know, but to the pagan herd thy wonders show." The Lusian host, enraptured, marked the sign that witnessed to their chief the aid divine. Right on the foe they shake the beamy lance, and with firm strides, and heaving breasts, advance. Then burst the silence, "Hail, O King!" they cry. "Our King, our King!" the echoing dales reply. Furred at the sound, with fiercer ardour glows the heaven-made monarch, on the wearless foes. Rushing, he speeds his ardent bands along. So, when the chase excites the rustic throng, roused to fierce madness by their mingled cries, on the wild bull the red-eyed mastiff flies. The stern-browed tyrant roars and tears the ground. His watchful horns portend the deathful wound. The nimble mastiff springing on the foe avoids the furious sharpness of the blow. Now by the neck, now by the gory sides, hangs fierce, and all his bellowing rage derides. In vain his eyeballs burn with living fire. In vain his nostrils clouds of smoke respire. His gorge torn down, down falls the furious prize. With hollow thundering sound, and raging dies. Thus, on the moors the hero rushed along. Th astonished moors in wild confusion throng. They snatch their arms, the hasty trumpet sounds. With horrid yell the dread alarm rebounds. The warlike tumult maddens o'er the plain, as when the flame devours the bearded grain. The nightly flames the whistling winds inspire. Fierce through the braky thicket pours the fire. Roused by the crackling of the mounting blaze, from sleep the shepherds start in wild amaze. They snatch their clothes with many a woeful cry, and, scattered, devious to the mountains fly. Such sudden dread the trembling moors alarms. Wild and confused, they snatch the nearest arms. Yet flight they scorn, and, eager to engage, they spur their foamy steeds, and trust their furious rage. Amidst the horror of the headlong shock, with foot unshaken as the living rock, stands the bold Lusian firm, the purple wounds gush horrible, deep, groaning rage resounds. Reeking behind the Moorish backs appear the shining point of many a Lusian spear. The mail coats, hauberks, and the harness steeled, bruised, hacked, and torn, lie scattered o'er the field. Beneath the Lusian sweepy force o'erthrown, crushed by their battered mails the wounded groan. Burning with thirst they draw their panting breath, and curse their prophet as they writhe in death. Arms severed from the trunk still grasp the steel. Heads gasping roll, the fighting squadrons reel. Fainty and weak with languid arms they close, and staggering, grapple with the staggering foes. So, when an oak falls headlong on the lake, the troubled waters slowly settling shake. So faints the languid combat on the plain. And settling, staggers o'er the heaps of slain. Again the Lusian fury wakes its fires. The terror of the Moors new strength inspires. The scattered few in wild confusion fly. And total rout resounds the yelling cry. Defiled with one wide sheet of reeking gore. The verdure of the lawn appears no more. In bubbling streams the lazy currents run. And shoot red flames beneath the evening sun. With spoils enriched, with glorious trophies crowned. The heaven-made SOV reign on the battleground. 3 days encamped, to rest his weary train. Whose dauntless valor drove the Moors from Spain. And now, in honor of the glorious day. When 5 proud monarchs fell, his vanquished prey. On his broad buckler, unadorned before. Placed as a cross, 5 azure shields he wore. In grateful memory of the heavenly sign. The pledge of conquest by the aid divine. Nor long his falchion in the scabbard slept. His warlike arm increasing laurels reaped. From Lara's walls the baffled Ismar flies. And strong Arancha falls his conquered prize. That unenaired town, through whose Elysian groves. Thy smooth and limpid wave, O Tagus, roves? Th illustrious Santorini confessed his power. And vanquished Mafra yields her proudest tower. The lunar mountains saw his troops display. Their marching banners and their brave array. To him submits fair Cintra's cold domain. The soothing refuge of the Naiad train. When love's sweet snares the pining nymphs would shun. Alas, in vain, from warmer climes they run. The cooling shades awake the young desires. And the cold fountains cherish love's soft fires. And thou, famed Lisbon, whose embattled wall rose by the hand that wrought proud Ilion's fall. Thou queen of cities, whom the seas obey. Thy dreaded ramparts own the hero's sway. Far from the north a warlike navy bore. From Elba, from Rhine, and Albion's misty shore. To rescue Salem's long polluted shrine. Their force to great Alonso's force they join. Before Ulysses' walls the navy rides. The joyful Tagus laves their pitchy sides. 5 times the moon her empty horns concealed. 5 times her broad effulgence shone revealed. When, wrapped in clouds of dust, her mural pride falls thundering black the smoking breach yawns wide. As, when th imprisoned waters burst the mounds and roar, wide sweeping, o'er the cultured grounds. Nor cot nor fold withstand their furious course. So, headlong rushed along the hero's force. The thirst of vengeance the assailants fires. The madness of despair the Moors inspires. Each lane, each street resounds the conflict's roar. And every threshold reeks with tepid gore. Thus fell the city, whose unconquered towers defied of old the banded Gothic powers. Whose hardened nerves in rigorous climate strained. The savage courage of their souls sustained. Before whose sword the sons of Ebro fled. And Tagus trembled in his oozy bed. Awed by whose arms the lawns of Betis shore. The name Vandalia from the Vandals bore. When Lisbon's towers before the Lusian fell. What fort, what rampart might his arms repel? Estremadura's region owns him lord. And Torres Vedras bends beneath his sword. Obadus humbles, and Alemquer yields. Alemquer famous for her verdant fields. Whose murmuring rivulets cheer the traveler's way. As the chill waters o'er the pebbles stray. Elva the green, and Mora's fertile dales. Fair Serpa's tillage, and Alcazar's vales. Not for himself the Moorish peasant sows. For Lusian hands the yellow harvest glows. And you, fair lawns, beyond the Tagus wave. Your golden burdens for Alonso save. Soon shall his thundering might your wealth reclaim. And your glad valleys hail their monarch's name. Nor sleep his captains while the SOV reign wars. The brave Giraldo's sword in conquest shares. Evora's frowning walls, the castled hold. Of that proud Roman chief, and rebel bold. Sertorius dread, whose labors still remain. 200 arches, stretched in length, sustain the marble duct, where, glistening to the sun, of silver hue the shining waters run. Evora's frowning walls now shake with fear, and yield, obedient to Giraldo's spear. Nor rests the monarch while his servants toil. Around him still increasing trophies smile, and deathless fame repays the hapless fate that gives to human life so short a date. Proud Bages' castled walls his fury storms, and one red slaughter every lane deforms. The ghosts, whose mangled limbs, yet scarcely cold, heaped, sad Trancoso's streets in carnage rolled, appeased, the vengeance of their slaughter see. And hail th indignant king's severe decree. Palmela trembles on her mountain's height, and sea-laved Zambra owns the hero's might. Nor these alone confessed his happy star. Their fated doom product a nobler war. Badage's king, a haughty Moor, beheld his towns besieged, and hasted to the field. 4,000 coursers in his army nate. Unnumbered spears his infantry displayed. Proudly they marched, and glorious to behold. In silver belts they shone, and plates of gold. Along a mountain side secure they trod. Steep on each hand, and rugged was the road. When, as a bull, whose lustful veins betray the maddening tumult of inspiring May. If, when his rage with fiercest ardour glows, when in the shade the fragrant heifer lows. If then, perchance, his jealous burning eye behold a careless traveller wander by, with dreadful bellowing on the wretch he flies. The wretch defenceless, torn and trampled dies. So rushed Alonso on the gaudy train, and poured victorious o'er the mangled slain. The royal Moor precipitates in flight. The mountain echoes with the wild affright of flying squadrons, down their arms they throw, and dash from rock to shun the foe. The foe. What wonders may not virtue dare? But 60 horsemen wagged the conquering war. The warlike monarch still his toil renews. New conquests still each victory pursues. To him Badage's lofty gates expand. And the wide region owns his dread command. When, now enraged, proud Leon's king beheld those walls subdued, which saw his troops expelled. Enragged he saw them own the victor's sway. And hems them round with battailous array. With gen-rouse ire the brave Alonso glows. By heaven unguarded, on the number rouse foes. He rushes, glorying in his wonted force. And spurs, with headlong rage, his furious horse. The combat burns, the snorting courser bounds. And paws impetuous by the iron mounds. O'er gasping foes and sounding bucklers trod. The raging steed, and headlong as he rode. Dashed the fierce monarch on a rampire bar. Low groveling in the dust, the pride of war. The great Alonso lies. The captive's fate. Succeeds, alas, the pomp of regal state. Let iron dash his limbs, his mother cried. And steel revenge my chains she spoke, and died. And heaven assented now the hour was come. And the dire curse was fallen Alonso's doom. No more, O Pompey, of thy fate complain. No more with sorrow view thy glory's stain. Though thy tall standards towered with lordly pride, where northern Phasis rolls his icy tide. Though hot Cyane, where the sun's fierce ray begets no shadow, own thy conquering sway. Though from the tribes that shiver in the gleam of cold Boötes what re-glistening team. To those who parched beneath the burning line, in fragrant shades their feeble limbs recline. The various languages proclaimed thy fame, and trembling, owned the terrors of thy name. Though rich Arabia, and Sarmatia bold, and Colchis, famous for the fleece of gold. Though Judah's land, whose sacred rites implored the one true God, and, as he taught, adored. Though Cappadocia's realm thy mandate swayed, and base Sophenia's sons thy nod obeyed. Though vexed Cilicia's pirates wore thy bands, and those who cultured fair Armenia's lands, where from the sacred mount two rivers flow, and what was Eden to the pilgrim show, though from the vast Atlantic's bounding wave, to where the northern tempests howl and rave, round Taurus' lofty brows, though vast and wide, the various climes that bended to thy pride. No more with pining anguish of regret, bewail the horrors of Pharsalia's fate. For great Alonso, whose superior name, unequaled victories consigned to fame, the great Alonso fell like thine his woe. From nuptial kindred came the fatal blow. When now the hero, humbled in the dust, his crime attained, confessed that heaven was just. Again in splendor he the throne ascends. Again his bow the Moorish chieftain bends. Wide round th embattled gates of Santorin, their shining spears and bannered moons are seen. But holy rites the pious king preferred. The martyr's bones on Vincent's cape interred. His sainted name the cape shall ever bear. To Lisbon's walls he brought with votive care. And now the monarch, old and feeble grown, resigns the falchion to his valiant son. O'er Tagus waves the youthful hero passed, and bleeding hosts before him shrunk aghast. Chocked with the slain, with Moorish carnage dewide, Sevilla's river rolled the purple tide. Burning for victory, the warlike boy spares not a day to thoughtless rest or joy, nor long his wish unsatisfied remains. With the besiegers' gore he dyes the plains that circle Bages' wall, yet still undimmed, with all the fierceness of despair inflamed. The raging Moor collects his distant might, wide from the shores of Atlas' starry height, from Amphilusia's cape, and Tingia's bay, where stern Antaeus held his brutal sway. The Mauritanian trumpet sounds to arms, and Juba's realm returns the hoarse alarms. The swarthy tribes in burnished armor shine, their warlike march of Bila's shepherds join. The great Myrmolon on Tagus' shores, far o'er the coast his bannered thousands pours. 12 kings and one beneath his ensigns stand, and wield their sabers at his dread command. The plund ring bands far round the region haste. The mournful region lies a naked waste. And now, enclosed in Santarian's high towers, the brave Don Sancho shuns th unequal powers. 1,000 arts the furious Moor pursues, and ceaseless, still the fierce assault renews. Huge clefts of rock, from horrid engines whirled, in smoldering volleys on the town are hurled. The brazen rams the lofty turrets shake, and, mined beneath, the deep foundations quake. But brave Alonso's son, as danger grows, his pride inflamed, with rising courage glows. Each coming storm of missile darts he wards, each nodding turret, and each port he guards. In that fair city, round whose verdant meads the branching river of Mondego spreads, long worn with warlike toils, and bent with years, the king reposed, when Sancho's fate he hears. His limbs forget the feeble steps of age, and the hoar warrior burns with youthful rage. His daring veterans, long to conquest trained, he leads the ground with Moorish blood is stained. Turbans, and robes of various colors wrought, and shivered spears in streaming carnage float. In harness gay lies many a welt-ring steed, and, low in dust, the groaning masters bleed. As proud Myrmolon in horror fled, Don Sancho's javelin stretched him with the dead. In wild dismay, and torn with gushing wounds, the rout, wide scattered, fly the Lusian bounds. Their hands to heaven the joyful victors raise, and every voice resounds the song of praise. Nor was it stumbling chance, nor human might. 'Twas guardian heaven, they sung, that ruled the fight. This blissful day Alonso's glories crowned. But pale disease now gave the secret wound. Her icy hand his feeble limbs invades, and pining languor through his vitals spreads. The glorious monarch to the tomb descends. A nation's grief the funeral torch attends. Each winding shore for thee, Alonso, mourns. Alonso's name each woeful bay returns. For thee the rivers sigh their groves among, and funeral murmurs wailing, roll along. Their swelling tears o'erflow the wide campaign. With floating heads, for thee, the yellow grain. For thee the willow bowers and copses weep, as their tall boughs lie trembling on the deep. Adown the streams the tangled vine leaves flow, and all the landscape wears the look of woe. Thus, o'er the wandering world thy glories spread, and thus thy mournful people bow the head. While still, at eve, each dale Alonzo sighs. And, O, Alonzo! Every hill replies. And still the mountain echoes trill the lay, till blushing morn brings on the noiseful day. The youthful Sancho to the throne succeeds, already far renowned for valorous deeds. Let Betis, tinged with blood, his prowess tell, and Bages longs, where boastful Afric fell. Nor less when king his martial ardour glows, proud Silva's royal walls his troops enclose. Fair Silva's lawns the Moorish peasant ploughed, her vineyards cultured, and her valleys sowed. But Lisbon's monarch reaped. The winds of heaven roared high and headlong by the tempest driven. In Tagus' breast a gallant navy sought the sheltering port, and glad assistance brought the warlike crew, by Frederick the Red, to rescue Judah's prostrate land were led. When Guido's troops, by burning thirst subdued, to Saladin, the foe, for mercy sued. Their vows were holy, and the cause the same, to blot from Europe's shores the Moorish name. In Sancho's cause the gallant navy joins, and royal Silva's to their force resigns. Thus, sent by heaven, a foreign naval band gave Lisbon's ramparts to the sire's command. Nor Moorish trophies did alone adorn the hero's name, in warlike camps though born. Though fanked with mountains, Leon's martial race smile at the battle sign, yet foul disgrace to Leon's haughty sons his sword achieved. Proud to his neck his servile yoke received. And, far around, falls many a wealthy town. O valiant Sancho, humbled to thy frown. While thus his laurels flourished wide and fair, he dies, Alonso reigns, his much-loved heir. Alcazar lately conquered from the Moor, reconquered, streams with the defender's gore. Alonso dead, another Sancho reigns. Alas, with many a sigh the land complains. Unlike his sire, a vain unthinking boy, his servants now a jarring sway enjoy. As his the power, his were the crimes of those whom to dispense that sacred power he chose. By various counsels wavered, and confessed. By seeming friends, by various arts, abused. Long undetermined, blindly rash at last. In ragged, unmanned, untutored by the past. Yet, not like Nero, cruel and unjust. The slave capricious of unnatural lust. Nor had he smilled had flames consumed his Troy. Nor could his people's groans afford him joy. Nor did his woes from female manners spring. Unlike the Syrian, or Sicilia's king. No hundred cooks his costly meal prepared, as heaped the board when Rome's proud tyrant fared. Nor dared the artist hope his ear to gain by new-formed arts to point the stings of pain. But, proud and high the Lusian spirit soared, and asked a godlike hero for their lord. To none accustomed but a hero's sway. Great must he be whom that bold race obey. Complaint, loud murmured, every city fills. Complaint, loud echoed, murmurs through the hills. Alarmed, Bologna's warlike earl awakes. And from his listless brother's minions takes. The awful scepter soon was joy restored. And soon, by just succession, Lisbon's lord. Beloved, Alonso, nam the bold, he reigns. Nor may the limits of his sire's domains confine his mounting spirit. When he led his smiling consort to the bridal bed, Algarbia's realm, he said, shall prove thy dower. And, soon Algarbia, conquered, owned his power. The vanquished Moor with total rout expelled. All Lusa's shores his might unrivaled held. And now brave Dinai's reigns, whose noble fire bespoke the genuine lineage of his sire. Now, heavenly peace wide waved her olive bow. Each vale displayed the labors of the plough. And smiled with joy, the rocks on every shore resound the dashing of the merchant oar. Wise laws are formed, and constitutions weighed. And the deep-rooted base of empire laid. Not Ammon's son with larger heart bestowed. Nor such the grace to him the muses owed. From Helicon the muses wing their way. Mondego's flowery banks invite their stay. Now Queenborough shines Minerva's proud abode. And furred with joy, Parnassus' bloomy god beholds another dear-loved Athens rise. And spread her laurels in indulgent skies. Her wreath of laurels, evergreen, he twines. With threads of gold, and Bacchus adjoins. Here castle walls in warlike grandeur lower. Here cities swell, and lofty temples tower. In wealth and grandeur each with other vies. When old and loved the parent monarch dies. His son, alas, remiss in filial deeds. But wise in peace, and bold in fight, succeeds. The fourth Alonso, ever armed for war. He views the stern Castile with watchful care. Yet, when the Libyan nations crossed the main and spread their thousands o'er the fields of Spain, the brave Alonso drew his awful steel and sprung to battle for the proud Castile. When Babel's haughty queen unsheathed the sword and o'er Hydasp's lawns her legions poured. When dreadful Attila, to whom was given that fearful name, the scourge of angry heaven, the fields of trembling Italy o'er ran, with many a Gothic tribe, and northern clan. Not such unnumbered banners then were seen, as now in fair Tartesia's dales convene. Numidia's bow, and Mauritania's spear, and all the might of Hagar's race was here. Granada's mongrels joined their number rouse host, to those who dared the seas from Libya's coast. Awed by the fury of such pond rouse force, the proud Castilian tries each hopped resource. Yet, not by terror for himself inspired. For Spain he trembled, and for Spain was furred. His much-loved bride, his messenger, he sends. And, to the hostile Lusian lowly bends. The much-loved daughter of the king implored. Now sues her father for her wedded lord. The beauteous dame approached the palace gate, where her great sire was throned in regal state. On her fair face deep settled grief appears, and her mild eyes are bathed in glistening tears. Her careless ringlets, as a mourner's, flow adown her shoulders, and her breasts of snow. A secret transport through the father ran, while thus, in sighs, the royal bride began. And knowest thou not, O warlike king, she cried, that furious Afric powers her peopled tide. Her barbarous nations, o'er the fields of Spain? Morocco's lord commands the dreadful train. Ne'er since the surges bathed the circling coast. Beneath one standard marched so dread a host. Such the dire fierceness of their brutal rage. Pale are our bravest youth as palsied age. By night our father's shades confess their fear. Their shrieks of terror from the tombs we hear. To stem the rage of these unnumbered bands. Alone, O sire, my gallant husband stands. His little host alone their breasts oppose. To the barbed darts of Spain's inim rouse foes. Then haste, O monarch, thou whose conquering spear has chilled Malacca's sultry waves with fear. Haste to the rescue of distressed Castile. O, be that smile thy dear affection's seal. And speed, my father, ere my husband's fate be fixed, and I, deprived of regal state, be left in captive solitude forlorn. My spouse, my kingdom, and my birth to mourn. In tears, and trembling, spoke the filial queen. So, lost in grief, was lovely Venus seen. When Jove, her sire, the beauteous mourner prayed to grant her wand-ring son the promised aid. Great Jove was moved to hear the fair deplore. Gave all she asked, and grieved she asked no more. So grieved Alonso's noble heart. And now, the warrior binds in steel his awful brow. The glittering squadrons march in proud array. On burnished shields the trembling sunbeams play. The blaze of arms the warlike rage inspires. And wakes from slothful peace the hero's fires. With trampling hoofs Evora's plains rebound. And sprightly neighings echo far around. Far on each side the clouds of dust arise. The drum's rough rattling rolls along the skies. The trumpets shrilly clangor sounds alarms. And each heart burns, and ardent, pants for arms. Where their bright blaze the royal ensigns poured. High o'er the rest the great Alonso towered. High o'er the rest was his bold front admired. And his keen eyes new warmth, new force inspired. Proudly he marched, and now, in tariffs plain. The two Alonzos join their martial train. Right to the foe, in battle rank updrawn. They pause the mountain and the widespread lawn. Afford not foot room for the crowded foe. Awed with the horrors of the lifted blow. Pale looked our bravest heroes. Swelled with pride. The foes already conquered Spain divide. And, lordly o'er the field the promised victors stride. So, strode in Ilaz vale the towering height. Of Gath's proud champion, so, with pale affright. The Hebrews trembled, while with impious pride. The huge-limbed foe the shepherd boy defied. The valiant boy advancing, fits the string. And round his head he whirls the sounding sling. The monster staggers with the forceful wound. And his huge bulk lies groaning on the ground. Such impious scorn the Moor's proud bosom swelled. When our thin squadrons took the battlefield. Unconscious of the power who led us on. That power whose nod confounds th eternal throne. Led by that power, the brave Castilian bard. The shining blade, and proud Morocco d'Ard. His conquering brand the Lusian hero drew. And on Granada's sons resistless flew. The spear staffs crash, the splinters hiss around. And the broad bucklers rattle on the ground. With piercing shrieks the Moors their prophet's name. And ours, their guardian saint, a loud acclaim. Wounds gush on wounds, and blows resound to blows. A lake of blood the level plain o'erflows. The wounded, gasping in the purple tide. Now find the death the sword but half supplied. Though wove and quilted by their ladies' hands. Vain were the mail plates of Granada's bands. With such dread force the Lusian rushed along. Steeped in red carnage lay the boastful throng. Yet now, disdainful of so light a prize. Fierce o'er the field the thundering hero flies. And his bold arm the brave Castilian joins. In dreadful conflict with the Moorish lines. The parting sun now poured the ruddy blaze. And twinkling vesper shot his silvery rays. Athwart the gloom, and clothed the glorious day. When, low in dust, the strength of Afric lay. Such dreadful slaughter of the boastful Moor. Never on battlefield was heaped before. Not he whose childhood vowed eternal hate. And desperate war against the Roman state. Though three strong coursers bent beneath the weight. Of rings of gold, by many a Roman knight. Erewhile, the badge of rank distinguished, worn. From their cold hands at Camoies' slaughter torn. Not his dread sword bespread the reeking plain. With such wide streams of gore, and hills of slain. Nor thine, O Titus, swept from Salem's land. Such floods of ghosts, rolled down to death's dark strand. Though, ages ere she fell, the prophets old. The dreadful scene of Salem's fall foretold. In words that breathe wild horror, nor the shore. When carnage chalked the stream, so smocked with gore. When Marius' fainting legions drank the flood. Yet warm, and purpled with Ambronian blood. Not such the heaps as now the plains of Tarif strewed. While glory, thus, Alonso's name adorned. To Lisbon's shores the happy chief returned. In glorious peace and well-deserved repose. His course of fame, an honored age to close. When now, O King, a damsel's fate severe. A fate which ever claims the woeful tear. Disgraced his honors on the nymph's lorn head. Relentless rage its bitterest rancor shed. Yet, such the zeal her princely lover bore. Her breathless course the crown of Lisbon wore. 'Twas thou, O love, whose dreaded shafts control the hind's rude heart, and tear the hero's soul. Thou, ruthless power, with bloodshed never cloyed. 'Twas thou thy lovely votary destroyed. Thy thirst still burning for a deeper woe. In vain to thee the tears of beauty flow. The breast that feels thy purest flames divine. With spouting gore must bathe thy cruel shrine. Such thy dire triumphs, thou, O nymph, the while. Prophetic of the god's unpitying guile. In tender scenes by lovesick fancy wrought. By fear oft shifted, as by fancy brought. In sweet Mondego's ever-verdant bowers. Languished away the slow and lonely hours. While now, as terror whacked thy boding fears. The conscious stream received thy pearly tears. And now, as hope revived the brighter flame. Each echo cite thy princely lover's name. Nor less could absence from thy prince remove the dear remembrance of his distant love. Thy looks, thy smiles, before him ever glow. And o'er his melting heart endearing flow. By night his slumbers bring thee to his arms. By day his thoughts still wander o'er thy charms. By night, by day, each thought thy loves employ. Each thought the memory, or the hope, of joy. Though fairest princely dames invoked his love, no princely dame his constant faith could move. For thee, alone, his constant passion burned. For thee the proffered royal maids he scorned. Ah, hope of bliss too high the princely dames. Reefest, dread rage the father's breast inflames. He, with an old man's wintry eye, surveys the youth's fond love, and coldly with it weighs the people's murmurs of his son's delay to bless the nation with his nuptial day. Alas, the nuptial day was past unknown, which, but when crowned, the prince could dare to own. And, with the fair one's blood, the vengeful sire resolves to quench his Pedro's faithful fire. Oh, thou dread sword, oft stained with hero's gore. Thou awful terror of the prostrate Moor. What rage could aim thee at a female breast? Unarmed, by softness and by love possessed. Dragged from her bower, by murd-rouse ruffian hands. Before the frowning king fair Inez stands. Her tears of artless innocence, her air so mild, so lovely, and her face so fair. Moved the stern monarch, when, with eager zeal, her fierce destroyers urged the public weal. Dread rage again the tyrant's soul possessed. And his dark brow his cruel thoughts confessed. O'er her fair face a sudden paleness spread. Her throbbing heart with generous anguish bled. Anguish to view her lover's hopeless woes. And all the mother in her bosom rose. Her beauteous eyes, in trembling teardrops drowned. To heaven she lifted, for her hands were bound. Then, on her infants turned the piteous glance. The look of bleeding woe, the babes advance. Smiling in innocence of infant age. Unobbed, unconscious of their grandsire's rage. To whom, as bursting sorrow gave the flow. The native heart sprung eloquence of woe. The lovely captive thus, O monarch, hear. If eer to thee the name of man was dear. If prowling tigers, or the wolf's wild brood, inspired by nature with the lust of blood, have yet been moved the weeping babe to spare, nor left, but tended with a nurse's care, as Rome's great founders to the world were given, shalt thou, who wearest the sacred stamp of heaven, the human form divine, shalt thou deny that aid, that pity, which e'en beasts supply. Oh, that thy heart were, as thy looks declare, of human mold, superfluous were my prayer. Thou couldst not, then, a helpless damsel slay, whose sole offense in fond affection lay. in faith to him who first his love confessed. Who first to love allured her virgin breast. In these my babes shalt thou thine image see. And, still tremendous, hurl thy rage on me. Me, for their sakes, if yet thou wilt not spare. Oh, let these infants prove thy pious care. Yet, pity's lenient current ever flows. From that brave breast where genuine valor glows. That thou art brave, let vanquished Afric tell. Then let thy pity o'er mine anguish swell. Ah, let my woes, unconscious of a crime. Procure mine exile to some barbarous clime. Give me to wander o'er the burning plains. Of Libya's deserts, or the wild domains. Of Scythia's snow-clad rocks, and frozen shore. There let me, hopeless of return, deplore. Where ghastly horror fills the dreary vale. Where shrieks and howlings die on every gale. The lions roaring, and the tigers yell. There, with mine infant race, consigned to dwell. There let me try that piety to find. In vain by me implored from humankind. There, in some dreary cavern's rocky womb. Amid the horrors of sepulchral gloom. For him whose love I mourn, my love shall glow. The sigh shall murmur, and the tear shall flow. All my fond wish, and all my hope, to rear. These infant pledges of a love so dear. Amidst my griefs a soothing glad employ. Amidst my fears a woeful, hopeless joy. In tears she uttered as the frozen snow. Touched by the spring's mild ray, begins to flow. So, just began to melt his stubborn soul. As mild rayed pity o'er the tyrant stole. But destiny forbade, with eager zeal. Again pretended for the public weal. Her fierce accusers urged her speedy doom. Again, dark rage diffused its horrid gloom. O'er stern Alonso's brow, swift at the sign. Their swords, unsheathed, around her brandished shine. O foul disgrace, of knighthood lasting stain. By men of arms a helpless lady slain. Thus Pyrrhus, burning with unmanly ire. Fulfilled the mandate of his furious sire. Disdainful of the frantic matron's prayer. On fair Polyxena, her last fond care. He rushed, his blade yet warm with Priam's gore. And dashed the daughter on the sacred floor. While mildly she her raving mother eyed. Resigned her bosom to the sword, and died. Thus Inez, while her eyes to heaven appeal. Resigns her bosom to the murd-ring steel. That snowy neck, whose matchless form sustained. The loveliest face where all the graces reigned. Whose charms so long the gallant prince enflammed. That her pale corse was Lisbon's queen proclaimed. That snowy neck was stained with spouting gore. Another sword her lovely bosom tore. The flowers that glistened with her tears bedewed. Now shrunk and languished with her blood embrued. As when a rose, erewhile of bloom so gay. Thrown from the careless virgin's breast away. Lies faded on the plain, the living red. The snowy white, and all its fragrance fled. So from her cheeks the roses died away. And pale in death the beauteous Inez lay. With dreadful smiles, and crimsoned with her blood. Round the wan victim the stern murderers stood. Unmindful of the sure, though future hour. Sacred to vengeance and her lover's power. O son, couldst thou so foul a crime behold? Nor veil thine head in darkness, as of old. A sudden night unwonted horror cast. O'er that dire banquet, where the sire's repast. The sun's torn limbs supplied, yet you, ye vales. Ye distant forests, and ye flowery dales. When pale and sinking to the dreadful fall. You heard her quivering lips on Pedro call. Your faithful echoes caught the parting sound. And Pedro. Pedro. Mournful, sighed around. Nor less the wood nymphs of Mondego's groves. Bewailed the memory of her hapless loves. Her griefs they wept, and, to a plaintive rill. Transformed their tears, which weeps and murmurs still. To give immortal pity to her woe. They taught the rivulet through her bowers to flow. And still, through violet beds, the fountain pours its plaintive wailing, and is named Amours. Nor long her blood for vengeance cried in vain. Her gallant lord begins his awful reign. In vain her murderers for refuge fly. Spain's wildest hills no place of rest supply. The injured lovers and the monarch's ire, and stern-brow justice in their doom conspire. In hissing flames they die, and yield their souls in fire. Nor this alone his steadfast soul displayed. Wide o'er the land he waved the awful blade of red-armed justice. From the shades of night, he dragged the foul adulterer to light. The robber from his dark retreat was led. And he who spilt the blood of murder, bled. Unmoved he heard the proudest noble plead. Where justice aimed her sword, with stubborn speed, fell the dire stroke. Nor cruelty inspired. Noblest humanity his bosom furred. The caitiff, starting at his thoughts, repressed the seeds of murder springing in his breast. His outstretched arm the lurking thief withheld. For fixed as fate he knew his doom was sealed. Safe in his monarch's care the ploughman reaped. And proud oppression coward distance kept. Pedro the just the peopled towns proclaim. And every field resounds her monarch's name. Of this brave prince the soft Deacon rate son. Fernando the remiss, ascends the throne. With arm unnerved the listless soldier lay. And owned the influence of a nerveless sway. The stern Castilian drew the vengeful brand. And strode proud victor o'er the trembling land. How dread the hour, when injured heaven, in rage, thunders its vengeance on a guilty age. Unmanly sloth the king, the nation stained. And lewdness, fostered by the monarch, reigned. The monarch owned that first of crimes unjust. The wanton revels of adult rouse lust. Such was his rage for beauteous Leonore. Her from her husband's widowed arms he tore. Then with unblessed, unhallowed nuptials stained. The sacred altar, and its rites profaned. Alas! The splendor of a crown, how vain! From heaven's dread eye to veil the dimmest stain. To conquering Greece, to ruined Troy, what woes! What ills on ills, from Helen's rape arose! Let a pious own, let banished Tarquin tell. On their hot rage what heavy vengeance fell. One female, ravished, Gibeah's streets beheld. O'er Gibeah's streets the blood of thousands swelled. In vengeance of the crime, and streams of blood. The guilt of Zion's sacred bard pursued. Yet love, full oft, with wild delirium blinds. And fans his basest fires in noblest minds. The female garb the great Alcides wore. And for his omphal the distaff bore. For Cleopatra's frown the world was lost. The Roman terror, and the Punic boast. Canius great victor, for a harlot's smile. Resigned the harvest of his glorious toil. And who can boast he never felt the fires. The trembling throbbings of the young desires. When he beheld the breathing roses glow. And the soft heavings of the living snow. The waving ringlets of the auburn hair. And all the rapt rouse graces of the fair. Oh! What defense, if fixed on him, he spy. The languid sweetness of the steadfast eye. Yet who have felt the dear, luxurious smart. When angel charms oppress the powerless heart. In pity here relent the brow severe. And o'er Fernando's weakness drop the tear. To conclude the notes on this book, it may not be unnecessary to observe that Camoies, in this episode, has happily adhered to a principal rule of the epopea. To paint the manners and characters of the age in which the action is placed, is as requisite in the epic poem as it is to preserve the unity of the character of an individual. That gallantry of bravery and romantic cast of the military adventures, which characterized the Spaniards and Portuguese during the Moorish Wars, is happily supported by Camoies in its most just and striking colors. In storming the citadel of Arzila, the Count de Marialva, a brave old officer, lost his life. The king, leading his only son, the Prince Don Juan, to the body of the count, while the blood yet streamed from his wounds, behold, he cried, that great man. May God grant you, my son, to imitate his virtues. May your honor, like his, be complete. End of the third book.